I remember when I was really young, I always looked at myself in the mirror and I would just stare at myself for a really long time. And I would think to myself, okay, this is what I look like. And I don't remember liking it. You know, growing up, I never felt pretty. I never felt like I was just beautiful. I don't know, I never felt like I was enough. And growing up, I was an only child. I'm still the only child. So I was a bit of a loner. There were a lot of things about me that made me different. I was the good little Christian girl. I didn't wear pants when I was in school, so that separated me from everyone everywhere. And people always felt like, well, she's too good or goody two shoes or whatever. And so that kind of pushed people away from me. And so on top of being an only child and spending a lot of time alone at home already, I would get out in the midst of all of these people and I was still alone. I remember people coming to me, even my friends or other students, coming up to me, and when they needed to talk about what was going on in their lives or in their families, when their parents were having issues, when they wanted prayer, they came to me. I was everybody's like confidant in secret. But when it was time to go to parties, when it was time to hang out, when it was time to do different things together with other people, I wasn't the one that was invited. And I'm like, okay, so people come to me when they need me, but they don't want to hang out. Like, what is wrong with me? And so it really took me a long time to come into my idea of beauty. I don't think I really got a real idea of what I felt beauty was until after all of that. Up until that point, my thoughts or ideas of beauty had been about the way that I looked. I had a friend that was dealing with some serious sicknesses and illnesses. And my friend was really popular and knew a lot of people and that type of thing. And so when you're popular, you know a lot of people, you always feel like when I need people, they're gonna be there. It's kind of like in that moment, they realized and I realized that popularity is not friendship. And so at that time when my friend really needed somebody, a lot of those people weren't really there. I knew that I was supposed to be there for my friend and I wanted to be there for my friend. And as they were battling with their sicknesses, you know, I spent just as many days and nights in the hospital as they did. At that time, I learned what it meant to sacrifice. And the more that I sacrificed my time, my effort, my energy, and lots of other different things, I realized I'm a really good person. I'm a beautiful person. Like, it doesn't even have anything to do with what I look like, but it's how I have the ability to make other people feel. And it's about being able to be there for somebody else and sacrifice. To me, that's the ultimate definition of beauty. When you can put yourself aside, when you can put your feelings aside, when you can put even your needs aside at that moment and say, hey, what do you need? Or how can I be there in a real way? How can I be a real friend to you, even when it may not be convenient to me? When you learn what you're willing to give, one, that's love. And so I believe that the ultimate definition of love is sacrifice, but I also think that that's what makes you beautiful. I realized that I was beautiful when I realized I know how to love a person. And I don't get it right every day. You know, it's something that I'm still working on. You know, I still work on, you know, how to speak to different people in ways that they'll understand. I've been reading a lot upon the 5 love languages. And I realize, you know, sometimes we love people the way that we want to love them. We sacrifice in ways where it's convenient or easy for us. But real sacrifice means I don't understand why you need this from me because this is not what I'm used to giving. But if this is what you need, I'm gonna learn how to give it in a way that you can understand. You know, my favorite kinds of people are the ones that are just sweet, just loving people that you just love to be around. Those types of people that make everybody feel good about themselves. And not that it's all rainbows and roses, because this is real life and I'm a very real person. But the most beautiful people are people that are just loving and good-hearted and that have kind spirits. I love being around those types of people because they're beautiful to me. My name is Jasmine Crumley. And I am a different definition of beauty.